Hello students, so today we are going to study the plant kingdom through questions. Now see, artificial system of classification was given by Linnaeus. If you know, artificial system was given by three people. It was given by Aristotle also. It was given by Linnaeus also. And it was given by Theophrastus. Artificial system of classification is based on few morphological characters only. It is based on morphological characters. And the Linnaeus was the one who has used number of this androtiums as a characteristics. So Linnaeus system of classification is based on androtium characters. So it is also known as sexual system of classification. Though it is artificial only, but it is known as sexual system of classification because he has used androtium character. Now see the next question. Question is, in which system of classification organisms belonging to the same taxa, they are having common ancestor? So that system of classification is phylogenetic system of classification. And that phylogenetic system of classification was given by Engler and Prandtl. They have given the phylogenetic system of classification. Now see what Bentham and Hooker has given. Bentham and Hooker has given natural system of classification. Linnaeus has given sexual system of classification. And Aristotle has given artificial system of classification. Though sexual system is also artificial only. But in the question they have asked, belonging to same taxa, they have common ancestor. It means they are focusing on phylogeny. Phylogenetic system, and phylogenetic system was given by Engler and Prandtl. So your option 2 will go the correct answer. See the next question. System of classification which was given by Bentham and Hooker. We know very well Bentham and Hooker system of classification is known as natural system of classification. It is based on natural affinities among organisms. So this is line you are finding it correct. It believes that organisms belonging to same taxa have common ancestor. No. Because this is a concept of phylogeny and natural system was not giving importance to phylogeny. So you will not select this option. Second option you can't take. Consider embryology, photochemistry and anatomy of the plant as criteria. Yes, they considered this. So your answer will be going the fourth option, both 1 and 3. Now see the next question, numerical taxonomy. Numerical taxonomy is also known as Adansonian taxonomy. It is also known as phonetic system of classification, in which we are making use of the computer. We'll be doing with the help of computer to analyze the data. We'll be considering many characters at a time. Many characters you can consider it. So you are preparing the three through numerical taxonomy that is known as your dendrogram. It is your dendrogram. Now see, cryptogram is for the phylogenetic tree. When you do the taxonomy or you do the classification by phylogeny, then you prepare the tree that is known as cryptogram. Now see the next question. How many features are common for all green, brown and red algae? So now see what, first of all, chlorophyll A will be there. Chlorophyll A is universally present from blue-green algae to higher plants. So this will be there. Aquatic habitat will be there. Because you know algae are found in the aquatic habitat. Thalloid body will be there. Thalloid body means the vascular tissues are not present. So we call that body as thalloid body. So this is the point will also be there. Cellulosic cell wall will be there. Though outside, alginic acid will be there, for the brown algae, agar will be there for red algae. Phycocolloids will be not present universally for all, because phycocolloids, your alginic and agar, are present only in the brown and red algae. Flagellate gametes will be absent in red algae. So in such question, if they are asking how many features are common, I think so the one which is double ticked: chlorophyll A, aquatic habitat, thalloid body organization, and cellulosic cell wall. So your answer will go 4 are the one which are common for all. Now next question: how many following structure in algae are motile? We have to find only motile structure. Zoospore is your asexual spore, which is motile. Chlamydospore is non-motile asexual spore. Echinite is also non-motile. Gametes of Chlamydomonas, yes, because it is showing isogamy as well as anisogamy to oogamy. So yes, it is motile. Gametes of Spirogyra, they are non-motile. This is very important question of NCERT. They are non-motile. Though it is a member of green algae with isogamous condition, but Spirogyra will make non-motile isogamy condition. Gametes of Fucus. Yes, gametes of Fucus, if you know, in the brown algae, Fucus is a member of brown algae, you are finding oogamy. The male gamete is motile. Gametes of Porphyra, no. Porphyra means red algae, and red algae motile structures are absent. A plano, A word means absent. Plano means motile. The motile structure is absent here. So what are the ones which are having motile structure? One is your zoospore, which will have motile structure. One is your gamete of the Chlamydomonas will be there. Then gametes of the Fucus will be there. So these are the one. To how many structures you're finding? One, you're finding two, and you're finding three structures. So these are the three structures in which you're finding the gametes, or you can find the structure is motile. So your answer will go first option. Now see the next question with respect to bryophyte. And they are asking sporophyte or bryophyte. Sporophyte means two end. And you know, in bryophyte, main body is N. In bryophyte, main body is N. And two end body is having three parts. We say foot, seta, and capsule. Capsule is a place where meiosis will occur to produce haploid spore. So now see the question. It forms by the reduction division of zygote immediately. This is wrong, because there is no reduction division, because here the embryo formation will be done. So they will make an embryo. The first statement is wrong because they are saying reduction division, that is wrong. Now 2N is free living. No. 2N is not free living, 2N is actual parasite over N. So that is why this statement is also wrong. It is more elaborate in mosses than in liverwort. Yes, the 2N sporophyte is more elaborate in mosses as compared to liverwort. Some cells of the sporophyte undergo reduction division and produce haploid spore. This I have already explained. Yes, they will produce haploid spore. So if you know, your A statement is false, B statement is false, your C is true, D is true, your answer will go second option. Now see the next question with respect to heterosporous pteridophyte. So first of all, to solve this, try to make a list of those pteridophytes which are heterosporous. Selaginella, Salvinia, Azolla, and Marsilia. These are your pteridophytes which are heterosporous. Now, heterosporous, they are telling, they have events which is precursor to seed habit. Yes, Heterospory gave them advantage that they can retain their female gametophyte, which is going to lead to the seed habit. They show female gametophyte retained on the parent sporophyte for variable period. Yes, this statement is also correct. They are exemplified by Selaginella and Salvinia, which I've already given you. Yes, they are exemplified by this also. They produce monoecious gametophyte. This is wrong. When they are heterosporous, they will not produce monoecious gametophyte. They'll produce dioecious gametophyte. So your answer A, B, C are correct. So second option will go your answer. Now see the next question with respect to cycas means gymnosperm member. If you know in the NCERT, difference is between the cycas and pinnas. First difference is with respect to root only. They are having corolloid root. And pinnas is having mycorrhizal root. Then stem difference. Cycas is having unbranched stem. And pinnas is having branched stem. Leaves, the difference is also there. It is having pinnately compound leaf. And it is having simple needle-like leaf. Then cycas is dioecious. There is male plant and there is female plant. Pinnas is monoecious. Now let us start solving. Unbranched stem, yes, it will be there. This feature will be there. Cycas is dioecious, yes, it will be dioecious. Leaves are simple, no. They are not simple, they are pinnately compound. So we will not select this option. Corolloid root, yes, they are having corolloid roots. Pollen grains are carried by air and insect. No, actually pollen grains are carried by air only, not by insect. So your answer A and B and D option is coming. It means first answer. Now see the next question. This is a general question for all the plant group. Who has shown the starting of the seed habit? If you know, heterospory was first started by pteridophyte only. So pteridophytes are the one which will show the seed habit. They are showing the seed habit, please. They are not making the seed. Seed formation is done by the gymnosperm and angiosperm. Sporophyte is not independent, but it is attached to photosynthetic gametophyte. This is feature of bryophyte because in bryophyte, the main body is N and 2N is parasite over N. Endosperm is haploid. Endosperm is haploid in gymnosperm. So gymnosperm are having haploid endosperms. And that is made before fertilization. So class students, please try to understand endosperm in gymnosperm and angiosperm. In gymnosperm and angiosperm, first see the difference. In gymnosperm, ploidy is N and here ploidy is 3N. It is made after fertilization in angiosperm. And here it is made before fertilization. I hope this practice would have helped you to improve. I hope this practice would have helped you to improve. Thanks for watching.
If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel.